Author of the article is a chap called M.P. Nathaniel, who is a former Inspector General of Police from the Central Reserve Police Force, that is CRPF. Mm. And it's about vacancies that remain unfilled in the government and in the states. We know that it's a common thing. Several times, it's an economy measure. Because have you all heard of Parkinson's Law? I have told some students in my class about that. Parkinson's Law is a very interesting, in fact, almost amusing, satirical kind of law, which says work increases to keep up with work increase in staff. Normally, we hire people when we have more work, isn't it? When you have more work to do, if you want to build one house, you need a certain number of people. If you want to build two at the same time, you need more number of people. Parkinson's law says no. In government, large bureaucracies, there are people already. So they find something or the other to do because they're already there to justify their existence. So that is why sometimes governments take the step of not filling vacancies as a measure of economy. When they find that they need money for development or regulatory purposes and they have enough staff already, they put a freeze on fresh appointments. But this article is not about that. This is about delays and neglect and procedures. See this, for instance, several posts the author points out. One is chairman of the National Human Rights Commission. The other is director of the CBI, the Chief Election Commission, etc. And there's a non-governmental organization, an activist body called the Association for Democratic Reforms, who have filed a PIL in the Supreme Court, a public interest litigation petition, saying that elections commissioner's appointment should be done by a more expanded committee. There's already a committee headed by the Prime Minister with the Chief Justice of India and the leader of the opposition as members. But what happens is if the Prime Minister hits upon a choice and the Chief Justice agrees with him, then according to the author, I don't agree with him, he says the leader of the opposition's voice is not heard. Naturally, if there are three people and two people agree about something, the third person, how can it happen unless there's a veto like in the United Nations? But somehow the author has a grievance. And so he says, let us have two more people at least. One chief minister, and I don't know, strangely he suggests one retired police officer. I mean, I'll come to that later, why strangely? But that is the author's suggestion. And those two other extra people, he says, should be men of proven integrity. Hmm? Then, of course, the author is right in pointing out that if vacancies are kept for a long time, what happens is they have an undesirable effect and impact on governance, and also delays in promotions and fresh appointments. They belie the hopes of people who are aspiring to be in those posts, either unemployed people or people expecting promotions, and also they paralyze administration, according to him. That is, provided those Parkinson's law is not working, if it is a lean and thin organization which pared to the bone, as they say. Have you heard the expression pared to the bone? Pared to the bone means with no extra flesh at all. That means absolutely, the minimum kind of staff is existing. If it is that sort of a situation, then not filling vacancies can mean the work not getting done. That is what the author says. He also says very rightly, after all, when an army chief retires or an air chief or a naval chief, the government always finds a successor a month before it is necessary to appoint the person. Why not elsewhere? Of course, one thing is that in the army, in all the three armed forces, promotions are very orderly. There is very rarely is there any dispute or controversy. So normally, the senior most person goes, so you know who is going to be the next one. So you issue an order well in advance. It doesn't happen in other, because there are various issues, politics, seniority issues, and then procedural matters, and etc. And then reservation issues and things like that. Now, finally, he says that all people should be appointed to the highest positions in the country well in advance. I can't argue with that. But let me point out some weaknesses in the author's, argument that there should be more people and one of them should be a chief minister, one of them should be a retired police officer. As I said, if two out of three people agree and the third one is left out, similarly, three out of five can also agree and the two will get left out. So whenever you respect the majority in an odd number of people doing making a decision, there will always be people whose opinion will have been heard, but will not have will not be the one which finally takes place. So I find this complaint rather strange. And then he has used the word of proven integrity. Now who is, as if the Chief Justice of India and he's not saying that these two are not people of integrity, but he's saying those should be, but who is to judge their integrity? Ultimately it will be the existing members. No, if you trust them, why do you want more people? If you don't trust them, more people will not help. So it is a classic case of the answer begging the question. I told you what that means some time ago. Yeah, and it's a case of information asymmetry. After all, if I believe that a person is a man of proven integrity and bring him, then if he is not, then whom will you blame? That means I myself am not a person of proven integrity, in which case nothing can be done. So either way, this system, I don't know, his suggestion doesn't hold much water. So that is one. Two, why a retired police officer alone? I don't understand. Why not an administrative service officer? Why not a foreign service officer? Why not an officer from the income tax or railway services or any of the central services? Or why not, in fact, a person from the armed forces? A retired army chief can also be put in the this thing. I see no reason at all. In fact, he will come from a completely different walk of life and probably bring a lot of objectivity and impartiality to the procedure of selection. So I find this argument rather strange. But I cannot disagree with him that top positions should be filled up well in advance, and then that they should not be kept vacant at all. In fact, I would like to tell you, as Chief Secretary, I insisted on the Chief Minister, Dr. Rajasekhar Reddy, choosing my successor. Of course, I also helped him choose him. And then when the successor was finalized, I made the government issue an order making me an officer on special duty and made him sit with me for a month as an understudy so that he could step into my shoes in a very harmonious transition. What is called hitting the ground running, it's called. You know, when a bus is moving and when you want to get on, you start running along with the speed of the bus and then only leave the railing so that, you know, you're stable. So that sort of arrangement I had made, and I think that is an ideal kind of thing to do. So this is my take on today's paper cutting. I'll be happy to take any questions or answer any clarifications, etc.